The first example suggests a continuous function. That means you're gonna use the given information and put all together in the xy plane and connect all information using the smooth curve. The first one, the g at negative 1 is 2. So we get the order pair, negative 1, comma 2. G at 0 equals 1, order pair 0, 1. G at 1 is negative 2. We get the order pair 1, comma negative 2. The g prime tells you about the derivative or the slope of the graph. So slope at 0 is 0. So that means you get the horizontal tangent. I'm going to take it out here. So going to be the horizontal tangent for both of them. So at 0 and at 1, the graph makes a turn. And then the next step, the next information, g double prime equals 0 at 0, and g at 0.5 equals 0. So the g at 0.5 equals 0 gives you the order pair 0.5, comma 0, where the g double prime will give you the hypercritical value. The point of inflection might occur at that point. And then for the interval from 0 to 0.5, the g double prime is less than 0. Less than 0 for the g double prime, that means I'm not happy. So that's going to be concave down interval. For the case of g double prime greater than 0, it's going to be concave up because I'm happy because we have the positive side. So this interval, the graph concave up from x less than 0 and x greater than 0.5. So I'm going to put our information on the graphing area here. As we have the order pairs, negative 1, 2, 0, 1, 1 comma negative 2, 0.5, 0. And the graph behaves the increasing, decreasing, concave up, concave down, and so forth. The x will be anywhere from negative 1 to positive 1. So I'm gonna make it as the increment here. This is negative 1, this is 0, this is positive 1. So I can see the 0.5 located on the xy plane. And the y direction, the maximum is 2, the minimum is negative 2. So go by the increment of 1 again. Okay, same way. So that I'm gonna locate the order pairs, negative 1, comma 2, 0, 1, 1, negative 2, 0.5, 0. Okay, we get 4 order pairs. So that means step 1, we get them all in, and then part of the step 3, or the list on the number 3. And next one, at 0, the slope is 0. At 1, slope is 0. At 0, slope is, I'm going to use different pen, different color, sorry. So at 0, the slope is 0. At 1, the slope is 0. That means I draw the horizontal tangent at that point on the curve. So get that one. And then g double prime at 0 equals 0. So that would be the point that the slope might change from one behavior to another behavior. We just leave it the way it is for now. But we're going to go to the topic number 4, which is like the interval from 0 to 0.5. The g double prime less than 0. So that means the graph concave down. So concave down for this interval. That means I'm gonna have the graph gonna be below my tangent line. concave down from 0 to 0.5. And then for the interval less than 0, the graph concave up. So the graph will be above my tangent line. Which is the same behavior as the portion or the interval greater than 0.5. And make sure it has the negative or the zero slope at the point x equals 1. So now I have my sketch graph based on information provided as the green curve here, where the I'm going to draw the horizontal tangent at the point 0 and at the point 0 at the point 1. So we get all information needed on the graphing area.